The first reading of the prophet Baruch is one filled with joy, even though the people were living in a sorrowful, deplorable state, because he predicted that God had not abandoned his people. God had in truth been with them in their suffering, and one day there would be a new Jerusalem. One day the people would again be set free. The Lord God would be with them. And so they should always have joy in their spirit. A great gift from God. And the responsorial psalm carries that theme of joy for the believer. Just the knowledge of being loved by and a follower of the God of all things visible and invisible should lift our spirits. Now, St. Paul, in his letter to the Philippians, carries on this theme of rejoicing. He owed so much to the assembly, the church at Philippi. It was in Greece, and when he arrived there, he was received with great hospitality. Lydia took him and his fellow evangelist into her home. He had support from the women, Eudaian Syndicate, who did so much for him that he said that their names were written in the book of life. And that community of Philippi would send him financial and personal support wherever he went on his journey. So when he went to Thessalonica, they would follow up with sending him sort of a care package of goodies so that he would be able to spend more time telling the story of Jesus than working with his own hands as a tent maker. And the same was true when he went to Corinth, etc. It seemed that the believing community were true partners with him in spreading the word of Jesus around the ancient world. So he says in today's reading, whenever I think of you with gratitude and joy. We're real partners in building up the kingdom of God on earth. And his prayer for them was a very special one. You already love God, you already love one another. I hope your love increases, your love grows, your love expands. And that's our prayer for one another. We are believers and we are lovers, but our faith has to expand and deepen, and our love for God and neighbor become ever more effective. Now, in today's gospel passage, we see love erupting in the world in the person of John the Baptist. He knew how tumultuous human society was and the depth and breadth of sin in everybody's life. And yet he felt in his very bones, and he felt this way from the womb, that the Messiah was near. A new age of love was coming upon the world, and the world wasn't ready for it. So he went preaching and teaching. He comes out of the desert and said, let's have a change of heart. Let's take our stony hearts and allow God to make them human, so that when the Lord of life and the Lord of love appears in our midst, we will be ready for it. And in doing that, John himself became a fulfillment of the ancient prophet from Isaiah, of that voice crying in the desert. That voice continues to cry in the desert of our world today and in this Advent season. All of us are called to prepare our hearts for the coming of Christ in the incarnation and to become vehicles of his truth and love in a loveless world. Now let us pray together the Nicene Creed, the summation of our faith.